fabulous Hotbox in the lovely and historic Ming Lounge of the even lovelier and more historic Republic Cafe here in classic, stinky old town Portland, Oregon. You guys, we're going to get fired up with your first comedian in just a second. But you know what I got to do? I got to tell the one joke I wrote this week, and it happened when I was reading the news. It was about people breaking light stands. Conor McGregor was in a fight over whiskey where he punched an old man in the face, which has got to be the single most Irish thing that's ever happened that didn't involve a potato getting fucked afterwards. I call Conor McGregor, that's the real Irish lottery. It's when an Irish person gets money, and the lottery starts with every person they're going to get sued by for the next 5 years until they don't have any fucking money anymore, you guys. And speaking of people who don't have any fucking money, coming to the stage is your bullet-taking comedian this evening. Let's give it up for a good friend of mine, Mr. Kevin Perez, everybody!
Hey, Kevin Perez is on stage. I just got the word from my manager, guys. We fucking sold this bitch out. I can afford it, don't worry. Okay, yeah. Thank you guys for coming out. You guys are very lovely. I think you're the only civilians here. And I appreciate you guys completely. My cousin's a little shit. He went to juvie for punching his dad in the eye and giving him a black eye. First I thought it was fucking lit. I was like, oh, I guess your dad was like beating on you or something, right? And he's like, nah. I was like, oh, he was like yelling at you? He's like, nah. He's like, he was sexually abusing you? He's like, nah. So I just punched him in the eye. I don't know, he was trying to have like a heart. This is what happened was my uncle was trying to have like a heart-to-heart with him because he's been getting in trouble at school. And my cousin's like a little shit, so he fucking punched him in the eye. Big props. I always wanted to punch my dad. One time me and my dad got into an argument when we were out landscaping together. It was very fucking like stereotypical. We got into an argument and I got pissed off, and then he had to go do something on the roof. So he asked me while I was pissed off to hold the ladder, and I almost fucking threw the ladder over and killed him. And like, yeah, I still regret not doing it. But I'm, I don't know. Anyways, my cousin went to juvie, and then when he got out, I was like, hey, dude, did you enjoy getting bumfucked in jail? And he's like, fuck you, man, I went to juvie, they don't do that in there. And I was like, oh, word, so you just got, like, finger banged or something? He's like, no, man, fuck you. And then he fucking punched me in the eye. It's fucking crazy. I never saw that shit coming, dude. Yeah, anyone who punches their dad in the face will punch anybody in the face, just to let you guys know. Anybody here ever beat up their parents? Oh, sick. You beat up, would you beat up mom or something?
We might have gotten into a fight.
Really?
Yeah,
bet you she's tough, dude. Moms are tough. I tried to beat my mom's ass. No, I'm just kidding. Mom's a cool lady. Mom has a mustache prettier than mine. Why'd you fight your mom?
Fuck, I don't remember. I was
she was saying some racist shit?
No, I was drunk as shit.
Was she drunk?
No, but I was in high school.
Oh, okay. Damn, bummer. Alright, let's talk about something else. I saw this lady the other day with quotation marks tattooed on her back. There was nothing in between the quotation marks. It was just quotation marks. I was like, sick. And then I ended up watching a YouTube video of this dude who fixes racist tattoos. I was like, dude, that's a fucking way to fix a racist tattoo right there. Just fucking put quotation marks on that motherfucker. You know? It's like white power. It's like Hail Hitler. And he just play it off like he's like a fucking really like fucking down ass comedian. He's like, no, dude, I wanted you to fucking racist joke, get it? It's sarcastic now. Sorry, it's not racist anymore. And everyone's just saying, what the fuck, dude? Fucking weirdo. I wrote a letter to my dick. Share it with you guys. It goes, dear dick, I promise to stop beating you if you quit standing up to me like you're hard or something. Yeah, I don't know. Never got a letter back. Fucked up. Shit's cool. You guys listen to the radio? My car doesn't have an aux cable, so I have to listen to the radio. It's pretty fucked up. It's low-key torturing, because one day I was like, oh, I'm on this radio station I fucking love, but they got like 5 minutes of ads, and you know, I was like, I'm gonna fucking power through these ads so I can get to that banger they're gonna play. After the fucking ads, it started playing that song where it's like, do you love pina coladas? And I fucking floored my fucking Nissan Ultima and wrapped it around a fucking telephone pole. And yeah, I don't have a radio anymore after that. I'm fucking glad. Works cool. I work with a bunch of Mexicans. I don't work, like, I'll frame and then they do drywall. So for some reason that makes me better than them. I don't know if you guys know construction hierarchy, but like here's the carpenters and the drywall guys are like a little bit below them. So then they go fuck themselves. I don't know if you guys know, but construction's like the manliest thing you can do. I wouldn't say it, but it's just things other people say that I would agree with, but I don't say that. Anyways, yeah, I was hanging out with these drywall guys in a room and we were working together. And one of them was like, hey man, you wanna watch some porn? I was like, hell yeah, I wanna watch some fucking porn right now. And we sat there for like 20 minutes watching these two girls go at it. It was cool. And then my boss walked in, you guys watching porn? Like, oh, no, it's just gay porn, boss. He's like, oh, okay, good. All right, and he just walked away. All construction workers are gay, pretty much. Like the gayest environment you can be in is hanging out with a bunch of like hot, sweaty men lifting stuff all day, operating power tools. I'm not gay, but like honestly, I'm on construction site sometimes. Like, dude, I wish I was gay. This would be paradise. Just like watch the manliest men ever like chop wood and swing hammers. It's fucking hot. For other people, not me. It's fucking hot. Yeah, some dude once told me that I was a hot construction worker. I was like, sick. What does that mean? Like, what does that mean? I don't know. I do chewing tobacco. Well, because I want the respect of other men. That's it. Is anybody else here chew? Anybody? Lady in the back. Yeah, I fucking love chew. Oh, yeah, I said it. Winter green, baby. The fuck I'm repping. I don't know. I'm afraid my teeth are going to fall out, too. And I don't want to be like a dude with no back teeth. I feel like that's weird, you know? You see a dude with like a pretty good smile, and you like see them at an angle, and they have no fucking back teeth, look like a fucking ghoul. That's some shit I'd be into. Oh, you don't have your back teeth, huh, for, right? You can't chew stuff. Fucking loser. Yeah, fuck you. Stupid ass, mustache, glasses, bald, old, poor, you dress bad. What?
That's not true.
Oh, okay. Hey, you're right. You're not that bald, so. Anyways, you guys have been great. Please enjoy your host and enjoy the night. Bye bye.
Tonight, Kevin Perez, everyone. I learned today that bangbros.com is not a hair cutting tutorial. It only took a couple hours, and I was like, oh. I learned a lot. But I do have a strict policy to always have a haircut that I regret within 10 years. And this one I call safe and affordable birth control. It's super effective. Because I don't know a lot about sex, apparently. My 73-year-old mom said to me, 69. 69, what does that mean? What does that number mean? I've heard it for years, and I'm like, And she's 73, so I'm like, ugh, I should just tell her and not be like, I'll tell you when you're older, because we don't know how long she has left. So I started to tell her, and she goes, why would you put that in your mouth? I was like, rent? I know. I love to torture her, so I was like, I'll make it better. I'll like, here, I'll give you a DVD of Mommy Dearest.
Yeah.
If you have not seen that movie, Joan Crawford does a really great job of beating her child with a wire hanger. Whoopsh, whoopsh. Beating her child. No more wire hangers. And I'm like, too late. Like, 7 years too late. And that's not how you beat a child with a wire hanger. Like, you do it like the rest of us. I know. That's not a joke about abortion, that's a joke about bad craftsmanship. You've got to use the right tool for the right job. I would like to introduce our next comedian. Come to the stage is Niraj Svin... I'm going to butcher this. Svinivisa.
Yeah! Let's lift it for the nice white lady for giving her honkiest. Oh, God, there's... nothing more sweet to me than Caucasian effort. It's a beautiful thing. It happens so seldom, and when it does, my dick moves. So thank you for allowing me to feel something. Yeah, my name is Neeraj Srinivasan. I'm 27 years old, which turns out is a very embarrassing age for an Indian guy to not be able to grow a mustache. And that's becoming difficult to come to terms with. Big news though, a few weeks ago in the shower, I discovered the first hairs on my butt cheeks. There are not many, but they are long, and it's very exciting. I thought my ass was like sealskin smooth. False. Right now, it has the same haircut as Gollum from Lord of the Rings. And it's like my hairline's receding a little bit, too, so it's only a matter of time until my ass has the same haircut as I do right now, and I have the same haircut as my ass from 10 years ago. Oh, no, that's just my bottom. Don't worry about it. I'm here to blow you guys up. Yeah, if you didn't laugh, that means you're concerned, and that means the rest of the set is not going to be fun for you. It's going to get real weird. You're going to be tempted to call 911. Do it. It'll be a great story. It might even make it into an album if I live long enough to... Okay, what was I saying? Holy shit. Yeah, ass hair, got it. Be proud. It's good to be back. I lived in Portland for about 5 years before I moved to Southern California about 6 months ago. Why? Because I got tired of hearing about seasonal depression. I got tired of hearing about it. If you don't know what it is, it's when white folks are mean to you for no reason. And then they blame a cloud. Like, it's, cloud is the reason they are a dick at a Whole Foods for no reason. But no, I moved to Long Beach because I'm poor, and I recently discovered that there's a Christian karate school in my neighborhood, which I didn't know was necessary. And I don't know if there's a lot of Christian karate schools, but if there are, this one cannot be the best Christian karate school, because the name of this Christian karate school is Christian Karate School. That's right. They didn't even try. And I've never been in there, but I just feel like the owner is a white guy with an Asian wife. You know, and he like wears a lot of cutoff t-shirts, and like he's bald, but he's also got like a cul-de-sac ponytail combo, and says stuff like really aggro but righteous stuff, like, here at Christian Karate School we believe in the two K's, karate and Christ, you know, that's stuff like that. It seems it's so confusing, like, what it wasn't Jesus' whole thing, don't fight anybody. You know, like, I've read the Bible. You know what? It needed more karate. It could have used a lot more karate. But it's just like, it's an oxymoron. It's like, hey, you seen that Christian karate school? Oh, yeah, it's right next door to that Mormon liquor store. Yeah, that's, oh, the one across the street from the Muslim strip club that shares the parking lot with the Hindu steakhouse. You know the one. It's, yeah, our most culturally diverse strip mall in Long Beach, California. That's completely possible, by the way. If you go down there, like, it's not like this honky deluxe town. Like, there is so much diversity. There's brown faces all over the place, and there's so many cultures mixing in so many special ways. And it brings so many surprises. Like, a few weeks ago, I met a Puerto Rican girl at an Irish pub in Koreatown. And a few days later, we had dinner at a Moroccan restaurant and then went salsa dancing. And later that night, while we were having sex, she called me the N-word. So, you know, and that was a surprise. I didn't know that was going to be a part of it, but, you know, at the time, I was disappointed. But in hindsight, like, something I was doing was reminding her of a big black dick. And in that way, it's hard not to feel complimented. It was too weird, though. We were, like, she was, like, walking me out. She's like, yeah, I had a great time tonight. I was like, yeah, I had fun. And pulls me in. We share a long, passionate kiss. Opens the door, and I'm like, about to walk out, and I stop, and I turn, and I'm like, I have to ask. I couldn't help but notice that while I was inside you, you called me the N-word 2 times. are you black? Like, it seems kind of uncool. Like, maybe you shouldn't be doing that. And she was like, oh, I'm sorry, I didn't explain. My sister's black, so she gets to say it. I get to say it. I was like, oh, I didn't realize that's how it worked. But yeah, this was fun. Thanks for having me over, bitch. She was like, what did you say? I was like, oh, sure, I didn't explain. My sister's a woman, so she gets to say it. I get to say it. She hasn't texted me back, but now I know that I actually don't get to say it. I don't get to say it. It's fucked up. I shouldn't be saying it. Thanks, bitches.
Let's give it up for the rush. Shimmy touch. Shimmy the sun.
My girl.
You know what? Wait, here. When Niraj said that he's an LA comedian earlier, I was like, does that mean he's going to run the light? And he didn't fucking run the light, which is, I don't think you're fully LA. You got to get a development deal, then you'll be running the fuck out of some lights, dude. He did say, can I go up earlier, but he wasn't enforceful about it at all. So, you know, it's like, he's a little LA, not quite LA. Question, is it cheek or creek where the hair is coming in, man?
It's all cheek, baby.
Cheek? When the cheek meets creek, it's backside full seat, baby.
Nobody so gets much it. To this culture.
I know, right? You know what's amazing, actually, is the similarities. The similarities, because, like, Niraj actually reminds me of my grandfather, because I actually heard him say, you're talking about there's so many of these different cultures mixing, but he wasn't optimistic when he said it. It was a different tone. Same words, very different tone. But you know who's got tone all over the place? Somebody who's very, very glad to be here. Very, very happy to have her in here this evening. She's, you know, I'm going to call you out. You gave us a miss last time. And the mic suffered for it. I'm going to be honest. The mic kind of, so it's kind of on you right now.
That's so sad.
You guys, she's going to lift it up for you. Let's give it up for the fabulous Miss Maddie, everybody!
I know everyone's talking about it, but the Portland traffic is getting out of hand. I was stuck on the Ross Island Bridge for over an hour. Why? We have all of this empty above river space. We should build more bridges. We should just have bridges across the whole river, just cover the whole river with bridge. Just one big bridge. And until then, guys, we're Bridges Town.
My roommate is so full of herself. She brags about how pretty she is. And she is very pretty. Like, if she just applied herself and gone to college, she could have totally been murdered. I think there's something wrong about people who eat food right when it's done cooking. Like, food is best after it's cooled down a bit. I like to enjoy my food. I like the taste of food. And if you eat food right out the oven or fresh off the stove, all you'll taste is hot. For this next bit, if I could please get y'all's audience participation, please. So, everyone look to your left and then look to your right. I have hemorrhoids and I went to the hemorrhoid clinic, and when the doctor was down there, I accidentally did the worst thing ever. She goes, I'm gonna stick my finger deeper now, okay? And I said, okay, Mom. Calling her Mom was weird because I call my mom Kelly. Cats are GD lucky that we've just decided their behavior is socially acceptable, right? Like, cats will straight up attack us, and we're like, aw, fair is fair, you know? Like, if we held cats to the same standards we hold dogs, they'd be perpetually punished. But to punish cats, instead of shutting them away all alone in a crate, we just shut the blinds.
I was looking at some bird shit outside, and like, are birds okay? I mean, their shit looks bad. That's why I stopped eating bread off the ground. I'm privileged because while I worry about the apocalypse, every day is the apocalypse for bugs. They're no match for such a big world. Everything is dangerous. Okay, I saw a daisy spinning in the wind take a ladybug's head off. That was... Okay, fuck you next. where am I? Oh my god, I'm only at 4. Okay, I want to try this. So I thought I heard my friend say they were a meth addict. But what they actually said was they were a math addict. And I was like, hey, dude, what the fuck's that? Like, what does a math addict do? And they said, a math addict fucks a guy to take Walmart's inventory. despite how I sound and look and act, I have depression. the first time I tried antidepressants, I was excited because I really thought they would get me high. But all they made me do was finally clip my toenails. I'm dating. I recently started dating, and I tried something I've never tried before. Shaving a landing strip. And mine was a fucking disgrace. So I texted my friend a pic, and she goes, dude, that's not a landing strip. You mowed a path right down the middle. I've never actually seen a landing strip before, and in my mind, you'd leave the grass everywhere but the runway. It looked like a meteor crashed in a field. Let's see. I'll do Unmas. So, I know my boyfriend's the one, though, because our health problems combined are sexy. I have carpal tunnel in both hands, so I wear double wrist splints. And my boyfriend wears a CPAP mask. And sometimes we play Batgirl Fucks Bane. Okay, thank you guys so much.
Thank you, Miss Maddie.
Damn.
Now I want to shave a landing strip just to keep things interesting. Which, incidentally, my boyfriend recently said, hey, we're in the middle of all the stuff. Hey, can I talk dirty? And I was like, yeah, you can talk dirty. And he was like, seriously? And I was like, yeah. And at that moment, it was like a water main burst. And fucking flooded the bedroom with swear words and like all sentence structure abandoned. All participles dangled. It was like, no, they're sticking in a butt, I'm pussy cutting, God, nothing made sense. And then he stopped. And I was like, oh shit, I'm supposed to participate in this narrative. And I didn't know what to say. I'm like, I need to practice. We've already been by the whole bang bros, so I learned some things. So, where do you practice dirty talk? I go to a dog park. I just like go in there, not with a dog either. I'm like, get over here, you fucking bitches! And I'm like touching buttholes, ass to mouth. Pick up a pug, breastfeed. I really let him have it, and I think I learned a lot, and I'm gonna bring it to the bedroom. I would like to bring Brian Bixby up next because I'm sure he can do a better job.
Woo!
Woo!
Hey, feeling pretty good. I took a great shit this morning. That usually does it for me. Yes. You ever take a shit so big it won't flush, so you just kind of set it on the counter, you know? Yeah. You know, like a shit so big you have to pay a pet deposit, you know? Anyway, I don't know. I take some big dumps. I don't know what to say. Like, if I eat a big enough meal, I'll go through 3 plungers. I will. I don't know. I'm trying to get healthy. I'm trying to be healthier. I bought a juicer, but you know, you don't get a lot out of a juicer. Like, I was really mad. I only got one shot out of a whole block of cheese. I was pissed. Anyway. What's that?
That's the best, dumbest joke.
The best, dumbest joke. Well, thank you. That's good. That's what I'm known for. Good, dumb jokes. Anyway, I got some new shoes recently. It's exciting. Actually, my friend got them for me. I usually shop for my shoes on Bukkake videos. You know? Anyway, whatever, fine. You guys don't watch the internet? What's wrong? I get a lot of ideas from porn. Like, one time I came on a girl's face, but I had no money, so that's called a sympathy shot. Alright, that was not as funny as I thought it was gonna be. I like to fuck on the dryer, so that she can fold laundry. I know. I have a pretty bad back. I need to see a chiropractor. You guys think, is chiropractics, is that a medicine, or is it just a back fetish? Which one is it?
Pretty orgasmic.
You got some kinks in here. Dogs. Let's talk about dogs. Actually, I only have one thing to say about dogs. Dogs really are man's best friend, aren't they? They really are. Like, if you kill somebody, who do you know who's more excited to dig a hole? That's a good thing about a dog. Anyway, even my girlfriend is bored with my material. I grew up in a small town. A lot of pedophiles in a small town. Yeah. That deserves an applause, guys. That's the only achievement a small town has, really. Centralize the pedophiles. Mess up the poor kids. That's what I'm... Anyway. A lot of them. I even knew about a pedophile in a wheelchair. Yeah, a wheelchair. How did he do it? Dress up as a race car bed? That's what I think. It's weird. He had to be very, very persuasive, right? Hey, kid, put my finger in your butt. That's the kind of thing, whatever. What I'm trying to say is anybody could be a pedophile.
Yeah!
I didn't mean that to sound so inspiring. Anyway. My balls are very sweaty. I have sweaty balls. My balls sweat like they're Googling how to wipe a hard drive. They're really very sweaty. I have some nice balls, though. They're pretty nice. I don't know. Much nicer than my dick. Much nicer. Like, it's like my dick is like a homeless man with nice luggage. My dick uses my balls to catfish women online. That's how. They're good balls, okay? A little bit baggy, though. A little too baggy. It's almost like my scrotum was a hand-me-down. That's how baggy. I could probably fit a bunch more balls in there, to be honest. Wouldn't that be great? Women love a lot of balls. Yeah, just get that surgery. Just look like a lumpy sack of onions, you know? Anyway. This guy told me it's really hard having a girl pee in his mouth. Because he always hurts his back. How? Right? Dude, just lay down. What are you doing? Keg stands? Like, how do you... It's pretty easy. Anyway. You know you're getting too fat when people recommend hard drugs? Yeah, just like, well, you know, a little bit of meth will clear those titties right up. You know that? Could really help. Could really be helpful. Anyway, I don't know. I had a lot more hope for some of these jokes than you guys did. I did. My favorite game as a kid was that game Operation. Because I always wanted to be like my grandfather, you know? So I would, you know, I'd take out all the little organs and then bury it in the woods, you know? You ever fart so loud you get caught living in somebody's basement? How about that? Yeah, you gotta be careful. You gotta fart into a pillow like Anne Frank. Yeah. I read that in her diary. That's when I read that. I read Anne Frank's diary. I did the pop-up version. It was fun. It was whatever. It's not always that good. Not always too great. I watch a lot of incest porn. Yes, I do. Not for the sex. I just like to fantasize being in a different family. That's what I like. Right? I'm like, wow, both parents are there. That's so sweet. What a lovely Christmas. This is nice. None of this has worked. 4 seconds to go. Do you guys know sperm swims to the egg? Which means it moves. And that must be why my socks keep going missing. Don't you think? Thanks a lot, Bob. Woo! Brian Bixby, everybody. You know, it's actually a really, it is a bummer when you get molested by somebody in this day and age, by somebody who's not famous, because there's so many really cool people you can get molested by. You know, when you're a kid, you just think, oh, everybody gets molested by Wayne, the guy that runs the 7-Eleven at night, you know, and then you find that other people are getting molested by Michael Jackson or taking to really cool islands in the Bahamas and stuff. I don't know, I guess I'll find a reason to be jealous, you know. Look, if it's gonna happen, I'm just saying, if there's a petting zoo involved, it's a plus, you know. All right, you guys. Coming to the stage is Jesus Christ, man. I'm gonna just blame Brian for that. I think because I think that the lack of faith in his material carried over to my pedophilia jealousy material. Brian, thanks a lot, man. I don't know. As Brian is actually one of my favorite comedians in Portland because he consistently demonstrates that Portland's funniest isn't really that important to you at all. It's just gonna do Brian, right?
Yeah.
Do fucking Brian.
Yeah.
Patrice Life, everybody do Brian. We're all going to see you later,
Brian.
That's right. People look at me and they don't think that I would have the fat problems too, but recently when I was standing in front of a restaurant, people showed me their ID. So I know that I'm getting really fucking fat, you guys. Security guard jokes. Coming to the stage is somebody who I also have a lot in common with. You know, we clean up after other people who don't fucking properly take care of their property. Let's give it up for my friend, Mr. Brian Kennedy, everybody!
I like how Chris brought me up by, like, getting everybody hyped up about Brian. Am I the only one that was, like, kind of bummed about that? Dude, if Chris's pedophile jokes can't work right now, I don't think anything I'm gonna do is gonna...
I like pedophile jokes.
Yeah, I bet you do, man. You look like the kind of guy that's down for pedophile stuff. Dude, every single time I use my broiler, I burn my fucking fleshlight. You know what I mean? No? Okay. Dude, I caught my fleshlight cheating on me with my butt plug. Like, he doesn't even like girls. I'm a maintenance guy in my apartment complex. I gotta like fix other people's shit. And this one guy asked me if I could change his light bulb. And it's just like, what? It's just like the most frustrating thing. Like, how lazy can you be that you can't just like change your fucking light bulb by yourself? So I go over there and knock on his door a bunch of times. He doesn't answer. And then he's like, come in. It's like, you can't change your light bulb. You can't even answer your door. Like, what the fuck are you doing for yourself? So I have the key. I open the door, go in. The guy's sitting on the couch. His belly's out. And he's got no hands. So I have to, like, back up my anger a little bit. I have to, like, pull it back. It's okay. Like, okay, so I'm going to change this guy's light bulb. But he's going through a weird life. And I think that maybe this is my chance to like inspire him. So I change his light bulb with my teeth. And I spit it on the ground like, see man, hey, you can do anything. And he's just like, yeah, but like I wear dentures anyways and I'm legally blind. It's like, if you're blind, why do you need light bulb changed? You know? I saw a crackhead mom fight at work. I should have left out the crackhead part because that's like later. But I saw some moms get into a fight. They were crackheads. But I did see them get into it. I was too far away to like to stop it, you know, to like get involved. So I pulled out my binoculars and gave a lot of attention to these women, which is like clearly what they're looking for. One of the moms like drops her kid on the ground, her baby on the ground to fight the other crackhead mom. Really sad. The other crackhead mom had clearly done this before, because her kid was calling the fight and taking bets. He pulled out the phone and he pulled out a hose to like muddy up the grass. He's like, get him, mom! Yeah, I don't know. It's just like, to get that place with drugs where you're like getting into fights and dropping your child on the ground, it's just like really fucked up. I mean, I've dropped my daughter, but I was just smoking weed. That's legal, so like, she's worse than me. I feel like cucks, that's just a funny word, you guys can laugh. Cucks, guys. No. I feel like cucks are like the cool dads of husbands. Like, no, yeah, you two just go upstairs, have fun, you know, just leave the door open. I'm gonna check on you guys, so get to it. My ex-wife's got a new boyfriend, and I really want to fight him, but I'm pretty sure he'd kick my ass. So I made a fighter on the UFC game that looks just like him, and then I made a fighter on the UFC game that looks just like me, and then we fought, and then he kicked my ass. Super awkward. Yeah, I was like on the ground, passed out. And then a fighter that looks just like my ex-wife comes in and starts fucking him in the middle of the octagon. It's like, I can't get away from this! I accidentally matched with my mom on Tinder.
Oh,
yeah. Dude, she's on it, and I just swipe on everybody. And of course, like, it was an accident on her end, because she's always been telling me I'm her favorite man. It's like, of course I am. Fuck. We're not going to tell anybody that we met on Tinder, you know. Like, no, we go way back. You guys ever go, Mom, when you're wiping lipstick off your dick? Oh, okay. That's just me. Okay. All my pants, I'm tearing through every single pair of my pants. I have a hole in them. I've been, like, putting on masks lately. I've been doing a lot of deep frying. Okay, well, that's just for me, I guess, then, because you guys don't like it. You guys don't like deep fried food?
Woo!
You guys are fucking lying.
Yeah.
We're going to move on like that didn't happen. Like, we're going to move on not like it didn't happen, but like I didn't awkwardly address how it did happen. We're just going to skip that part. I convinced this girl to let me give her a heart tattoo on her butt. Yeah. but I'm not very good at tattooing. So it just looks like a swastika. No, it's cool. It looks like the Hindu swastika that's like means for peace when she shakes her ass. So it's nice. I'm getting an American flag tattoo on my leg. I'm working on it. Unpopular decision, apparently. People don't like America. And I'm nervous because like, what if someday like the stars and stripes are like an old school symbol of like hatred and oppression, and I have to get this tattoo covered up? Like, that'd be really fucked up because I just got this tattoo to cover up my swastika tattoo. Fuck. Got a daughter. Maybe I shouldn't, but I do. That's just how it goes. People say I'm too young. They're right. I'm a really good dad. In public. I don't spank my daughter until after we get home when she forgets what she did wrong. That's where I put it. That's where that belongs. No, I really don't spank my daughter. I did once. I spanked her once. And now it's just like, oh, you know what? We're not going to do that again. But now she knows that I've got this little thing that, like, we can whip out anytime you're misbehaving. I feel really bad. It's like, it's one of those things in my history that I'm not, like, happy that it happened. But at the same time, it's like, okay, so I got really pissed off. And I spanked the fuck out of her booty. I dropped nuclear bombs on that booty, like Hiroshima. One on each island, and now she knows. Now she knows, don't fuck with America. It's like, now she knows, don't fuck with that. I don't know. No, seriously, it was bad. I dropped the Twin Towers on that booty. Free falls key, pop, pop. Never forget. No? Okay, guys, that's all my jokes. Have a good night.
Bram, that's a perfect segue for me to talk about how no one will let me babysit their children anymore. Not because of the creepy witch vibe, but because they don't like coming home to, like, chalk outlines of their children. The kids loved it. They absolutely loved it. And I don't have children. I've never wanted them. I kind of feel like there is a spectrum of, like, people who really, really, really want children, and then the other end is people who really, really, really want to take kids to a pig farm and send them back to God. I'm somewhere in the middle. That was terrible. I'm somewhere in the middle. Hopefully, our next comedian, Kyle Curtis, has something better to say about kids. Thank you.
Well, now I'm put on the spot. Jesus.
Oh, man.
There's this misconception that doing stand-up comedy is hard. It's not. You know, like, I talk to people and they're like, oh man, I can't believe you do that. Oh, you're so courageous. You're so brave. I was at the bar here one time. The guy next to me overhears that I was doing comedy. He's like, he literally said, you're my hero.
Oh my God.
And I'm like, yeah, you know, there. On one hand, there's like firefighters rescuing kids from burning buildings. On the other hand, I tell dick jokes. Yeah, it measures out. It's legit. You know, but like, what's this whole thing? Like, oh, it's so, oh, I can't believe you do that. Oh, it's so, like, why? Because I expose myself naked and vulnerable in front of a room full of strangers? I mean, can you imagine doing something similar to that here in Portland? I mean, that's a pretty unique, like, description for a profession, right? Like, can you think of anything else that you could do in Portland along those lines? Besides being a stripper, of course, that's what I was leaning to. Like, I mean, it gets like, when I say that in the strip club, it gets a legitimate laugh, you know? Like, granted, it's not hard to make a stripper laugh. That's kind of like, you know, their job. Well, actually, their job is take off their clothes and make you give them a bunch of money to do that, but nobody finds, like, a pissed off stripper, like, sexy. Like, I don't know, maybe some people find that, I don't know, like, it's not my, you know, whatever. But, like, you know, the conversation always goes back to, so what do you do? And I say, oh yeah, I'm a comic. I expose myself naked and vulnerable in front of a room full of strangers. What do you do? And then they laugh, and then they say, oh, kind of the same thing. And I say, oh, we have so much in common. Sparkles, or Phoenix, or Skittles, or whatever your fucking fake name is today. But anyway, it's not hard to be, it's not hard to be a stand-up comic. You just think of a silly joke, you get on stage, and you tell it to a microphone. It's that simple, right? I'm going to prove it right now, okay? What does a Tyrannosaurus Rex use? Okay, no, I fucked it up. I'm gonna take a mulligan on that one. Okay, super easy, the easiest thing. Okay, I'm gonna do it right this time. What does a dinosaur use to pay his bills? Tyrannosaurus check. See?
Hey.
Easiest fucking thing. Easiest thing in the world. Here's another one. What is a dinosaur's favorite brand of breakfast cereal? Tyrannosaurus chicks! I telegraphed that punch, oh my god! Easiest thing. So easy. Okay, anyway, enough of that shit. I've been getting caught up on the news. Have you guys heard about this lawyer that's a sex addict?
Yeah.
Yeah. You'd say he's pro-boner?
Yeah.
Pro-boner. It's another way of saying sex positive, by the way. Fucking dumb. Anyway, so I'm wearing this like Evil Dead t-shirt. Or is anybody here like fans of horror movies? Anybody? Did you see the Slender Man movie? Also known as the documentary about me? I'm not saying I'm not skinny or anything, but flamingos are envious of my legs. I don't even know what that means. Like, but do flamingos look at me and they're like, damn, I wish my legs could be that skinny? Or they look at me and they're like, fuck, he never misses leg day. You know, like, I don't know. You know, I wrote the joke and I don't get it. Maybe somebody can explain it to me later. I was told that this past week looks like I lost weight, which is great because my target weight goal is to fade away into non-existence. Like smoke on the wind, you know? I look like I should be the poster child for body by cocaine, which would be great if I did cocaine. You know, I'm not going to say I've never done cocaine, because anybody who says that is a liar, but I don't do as much cocaine as it looks like I should. Nervous, oh, everything's better on cocaine, sex is better on cocaine, dance is better on cocaine, party and bonfire on the beach is better on cocaine. The one thing that nobody has ever said is better on cocaine, taking naps. Nope, the words taking naps is better on cocaine has never been uttered until this moment right now. And naps are like, they're kind of like, I mean, cocaine's it's just not my high, right? But naps are like, they're like my tang. Have you guys heard this? My tang? Yeah? I'm not sure if this is like new millennial slang or if like a misguided Gretchen Wiener's fetch thing. But I was like sitting at a bar after a mic. Maybe I was just sitting at a bar because that's where I like to sit. And I was sitting next to these two women, and one of them orders a Sprite and tequila. She gets her drink, and she takes a sip, and she says to her friend, oh, yeah, Sprite and tequila, that's my tang. And I overhear this, and I'm like, what? What the fuck? And I'm just like a dude. I'm just sitting there, like, nobody's asking me, like, my opinion. I should just not say anything, right? But I had wet mouth, where my brain's like, don't say anything, don't say anything. And my mouth's like, fuck you, I'm talking. And I turned to her, and I said, oh, did I just hear you say that's your tang? And she said, yeah. And I said, I've never heard that. I've always just heard people say that's my jam. And then she said, well, what's your jam? Without a moment's hesitation, I said, space! Worth it solely for the look she gave me as she slid off her stool and walked away. You know, there's this book like How to Win Friends and Influence People. My version is How to Alienate and Off-Put People. I'm like three chapters in. I'm pretty sure it's gonna sell. Not at all, but you know, I have to find something to fill my time. But anyway. So taking naps, I love them. Cocaine's not my high. Heroin's probably my speed, you know, slow as fuck. And I've lived in the Northwest like 40 years. I've never done heroin, right? And I was going to treat myself when I turned 40 last summer to shoot up heroin for the first time. I got talked out of it, and I feel disappointed because I feel like I got talked out of a really nice nap. Anyway, so I did. I went back home to my hometown, and I was doing comedy there. My mom's like, oh, I want to see you do comedy. And I said, great. So I did that set for her in front of a room of other comics that I've never known. Like, maybe some I met a couple times. And I finished that set. I said, hey, everybody, my mom's here. I guess she really wanted to hear me talk nonchalantly about snorting cocaine and wishing I showed up heroin, you know? Like, she had that on her bucket list. Like, is my son a degenerate burnout? Confirmed. Hope I made you proud, Mom. Anyway, my name is Kyle. You guys have been fun. And I want you all to remember, you know, they say the heart of rock and roll is still beating. And from what I see, I believe them. All right, thank you. Have a good night. I close with a Huey Lewis line. I like that he wants the audience to explain that. You kind of need like an Oracle of Delphi to fucking sort, you know, you're just blah, 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 blah. And it's like speaking on tongues. You get the other person in the room to go, he says something from Matthew. Probably not. Matthew's the good one, you guys. It's getting quoted a lot recently. There's a lot of great stuff in Matthew. So I get obsessed. I try to prepare for situations a lot because I'm trying to drown out a lot of the shit that's going on in my head. Sometimes I'll watch a movie and I'll start preparing.
Here's what I've been preparing for lately. What would I do if I was retarded? Because here's the thing. According to the Harrison Ford film regarding Henry, it can happen. Some shit could fall out of the sky. And the reason I'm spending a lot of time in it is because I feel like after, it's going to be too late to really do a lot of thinking about what I should be doing. You know what I mean? So I've decided if I'm suddenly retarded, I'm just going to become an alcoholic to kind of cover for the whole situation, you know, like the slurs. And then it made me thinking, and I don't know, maybe it's my time here at the Republic Cafe, but I wonder how many people have already adopted that plan. Go to the front of the bar. Maybe you can answer that question for me. You guys coming to the stage. It's a good friend of mine. He's one of the few, the proud, who have been to my home and lived to tell the tale about it. He didn't end up in my freezer. He's a very funny guy. Let's give it up for Mr. Robert Manel, everybody!
What's up, guys? You doing all right? Yeah, Chris, I'm so glad you got a laugh at the end of saying retarded five times in a row. I was nervous for you, but that's the risk you gotta take, and you pulled it off. What's up, guys? I know I am bringing like a confusing look to the stage tonight. This area tonight. My shirt says I have a margarita maker in my basement. And my face is, I have your daughter in my basement. So, I'll turn and look so the folks can see and not, and they didn't care. All right. I think I'm one of the only people that looks like a bully and a magician. Is this ringing true with anybody else? There we go. Okay. They rock with that one. Yeah, I look like I played for the Mariners as their starting sex trafficker. And I can make that joke. My uncle's a sex trafficker. All right. My uncle is Jeffrey Epstein. Does anybody pay attention to the news? Yeah? Okay. I wish that...
I got in trouble for it.
Hopefully you're not talking about what I think you're talking about. You weren't hanging out with Jeffrey Epstein when you got in trouble, were you?
No.
Oh, okay. All right. Yeah, I'll just continue then. All right. I'm just... that whole scandal, man, it's like, I think it points to a big imbalance in our culture, you know? The shit that's going down. Like, we have these phones, like, we can traverse the country, like, with just our phones, using, like, GPS. Like, the technology is amazing. Yet we can't stop my uncle from rounding up like a 114-year-old to massage him every weekend. You know? I don't think any society has gotten the balance just right, you know? Like, even the Aztecs, who we praise, like, you know, so much for their ability to map the cosmos, they had a horrible imbalance in their society, you know? Like, they could have put some of that effort into their sports culture a little bit, you know? Like, if I were an Aztec, I'd be like, oh, you know where the North Star is going to be in 200 years? That's cool. Can you explain to me why you just got done playing soccer with my kid's head? Maybe then I'll fucking, you know, I'll care about your Cosmo thing. But right now, little Jimmy's fucking no longer with us. And I know the home team won the championship, but I'm sad. All right, so I think we got some work to do. Yeah. Yeah. Think about culture. White people, why would we think that dream catchers would work for us? We know who invented those, right? Yeah, I don't think, it's almost like you get a charm bracelet, right? And then, your friend gives you like a charm bracelet, and then you go over to your friend's house and you kill his entire family and his entire people. I think that bracelet might lose some of its charm. You know what I'm saying? These are just theories, guys. they're kind of dark, but let me think out loud. You know? Yeah, I'm very progressive. I look for culture, but. Appropriation, wherever I can find it, you know, like, I'm on the lookout. Like, I heard there's cultural appropriation, I can't even speak tonight, that's what's happening, guys. I heard there's cultural appropriation between China and Japan, you know, and I would tell you who's doing the appropriating, but I can't tell them apart. that's just, sorry. where are we? You know what I was doing some reading.
I really want to chat.
What?
I, like, when you said, where are we, I said, I really want to shout out the address.
I like your orthopedic shoes.
What the fuck is happening? You can't just double heckle me with two things that make no sense.
I'm bad at whispering.
You may have thought I asked you something, sir, but there are a bunch of witnesses in here. No one asked you anything, which might explain the fact that you said, like, 27 words and none of them had any relation to each other. But I commend you. It probably made sense in some, I don't know, if I gave you 5 minutes, I'd probably understand some form of, whatever. I got 2 minutes left.
Your dream catcher joke is almost there!
George, I hate that you're getting the biggest laughs of my set right now. Whatever you do.
I like tell me some jokes.
Well, all right. I think George has taken over this one. I don't know how I can win it back. You want some jokes for real?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay. Everyone's supportive now. I thought everyone was on, George's side. What the fuck? I know, okay, well, I know the joke isn't all the way there, but you know this process, George.
I'm trying to stay out of the way.
We can tell that you know a lot about processes by just your general look and everything. All you think about is processes and how they might affect your next move in this world. You think of about 3,000 processes before you say another word, I'm pretty sure. But it's all good, we love you. And I have another joke that I'm going to attempt. Or not. I think that was it. All right, peace out. Thank
you. Keep it going for Robert Minnell. Woo! Damn. I feel like somewhere in there it brought to my mind the concept of double dong. I don't know why. I'm going to just say, I don't know what he said that it reminded me of Double Dong. A friend of mine dates a lot on dating apps. I don't know how they work. I don't date. I don't know how to do that. And she's like, it's not working. Like, I keep trying to date. Swipe, swipe, swipe. Nothing happens. Or she'll go on, like, a date, like the year of first dates. And I was like, oh, okay. And she's like, help. Gives me her phone. And I'm like, okay, let me look. And I take a look at it, and I'm like, oh, girl, no. No problem. You just need conditioner, but not in your hair. Just kind of squirt it across your face and like, click. Make it look like Fleetwood. Definitely gonna get a response there. I know. Sounds rough. It is rough because a lot of the first dates, I'm like, how honest do I be with her? Because I really was like, is she really asking advice? I'm like, okay, just say it. I'm like, stop making kimchi at home. Like, your fucking house smells like no dates. Like, I just imagine these suitors showing up like, ding dong. And she opens that cargo bay door. And they're just like lawn ornaments. If you're successful, it can lead to a one-night stand. And in the event of you not wanting that person to be there for very long, I have a little intel for you. This is how to unfuck on Tinder. Let's say they're there the next day, and they're like, hey, do you want to hit it again? You say, oh, geez, oh, your friends only paid for one night. So sorry. I am very excited to bring up our next guest. I want to hear what he has to say. This is Thomas McCrone. Woo! Hands together.
Give it up for Amy. Nice to meet you. It's a fucking solid name, I gotta tell you. Fuck, I keep seeing people like keeping this here, so I'm just gonna do my impersonation of how I make black people blush. It's called They Take Me to a Club. and a song from Atlanta comes on, and they're from Atlanta. So they're trying to teach me how to dance, and that's fun. But there's a lot of songs that come out of Atlanta, and my white ass, I cannot learn 8 dances in a night, so I just started doing this. It's versatile. You can jerk off two dudes in like almost any situation. You can be like, that's where I'm just like randomly grabbing dicks. You can do, and that's like where you're like jerking dudes off while you're skiing. It's a fucking great move. I have to go to a wedding, and every time I ever say yes to something, I end up having to do the whole thing. Like, I didn't realize by saying yes, clicking beef, that I had to help them with the wedding. Do you have friends? Do you have friends? Friends fucking suck. Fuck those dudes. Like, fuck all my friends. They are so needy and also never there when they're not needy. When they're not needy, they're like, hey, you got a show coming up? That's great. Hey, can you, do a sous chef thing at my wedding and like do what's the thing before the wedding where you get everyone together and you pretend you have a wedding? Is that like called like, what's it called?
Rehearsal dinner?
Yeah, can you do my fucking rehearsal dinner? Like, can you like help us set up tables and like take an entire weekend out? It's like, what do you think the venue's gonna be? It's gonna be like 40 people. I'm like, motherfucker, I hit maybe, and I hit beef, and that's all I did on Facebook. I had a bad glory hole experience the other day. Sometimes you don't check to see if you should have eaten Taco Bell earlier. Sometimes you don't check to see if there's toilet paper. Sometimes you don't check to see if the bathroom is just fucking locked like a fucking prison. Like, how the fuck do I get into this bathroom? Like, have you guys tried to use the bathroom here? Like, you go up there, like, seriously, like, and like, this is like obviously authentic Chinese restaurant, because this elder lady from, I guess, China just shouted gibberish nonsense to me and then guided me through someone's set to go use the bathroom and like yelled at me during a dude's set. And I'm just like, all right. And I guess this is the way that works. I'm like expecting almost a Saw scenario. I was really, really hoping, to walk back there and just find like a human caterpillar or some shit. I don't know what that movie was about. I didn't watch that shit. I also didn't watch Leaving Neverland, because fuck that. I'm like, oh, that's fine. Like, I heard about it on Twitter. That was enough. So R. Kelly's a piece of shit. So anyway, I was back in this glory hole. I forgot I was telling a story. I totally forgot where I was at. So, I know how I got myself in this situation. It was called, I trusted a fart, and that didn't go well. Hey, you guys ever trusted a fart? You have to do this, like, weird Deion Sanders walk, but you're in slow motion the entire way. Like, I had to, like, check an ID at the door, and this dude just looks at me, he's like, what's going on, man? I'm like, I thought it was gonna be classy and fart after I got out the car, but now that's a shark. He's like, go. Just go. It's really weird when a giant black dude has empathy for a little white dude, but that's my life. That's my life. So I fucking run in here. I'm like, I run, slow-mo walk, panic. I'm like sweating. Like, I'm really, really trying to keep my underwear at this point of my evening out. And so I'm like, I walk into this bathroom, and we literally came to this bar because my friend told me it was the shittiest thing you'd ever seen. I was just like, oh, I totally have to go see that. And then I tried to get out the fucking, out the Uber. I'm like, I'm gonna be a classy. I'm gonna like rip this giant fart I've been waiting to rip. I don't know what that verb is. Rip this fart, and it became disastrous. And sometimes you don't check to see if there's fucking toilet paper. Sometimes you don't notice there's a fucking hole next to your head. And then some dude named Greg just starts talking to you while you're hovering over a toilet you don't want to shit in. And you're just like, have you ever had diarrhea hit you in the back of the eyeballs? Because that feels like an aneurysm. So my light flashed before my fucking eyes. And Greg was nice. Because he wasn't throwing a dick at me. But I never had to think about dealing with a fucking random dick before. Sorry, white male privilege. Dicks just don't come flying at my face all that often. These are the three thoughts I had. One, I'm going to break the fuck out that dick. Two, like I was going to grab that shit and just break it. Two, punch it like a shark. Three, I'm grabbing this shit and asking for all his money. And just like robbing this motherfucker. But Greg was cool. He realized he fucked up my shit and apologized and bought me a drink. This dude's named Greg are awesome. Fuck everyone named Chris. Much love. Sorry, Chris. I didn't see you there. Much love. This is a great mic.
Give it up for Thomas McCrone, everybody. Oh my goodness. You know, I guess with all that fart discussion, now's as good a time as any to talk about immigration. Here's the thing. I am a descendant of immigrants. I assume most people in this room, or at least partially, or maybe almost completely descendant of immigrants. And I really think that the immigration anxiety that this country experiences is kind of a two-way anxiety, and it really does boil down to farts. It comes down to fucking waves of new smells that we're all worried about either exposing people, strangers to, or being exposed to. My grandparents, my grandfather when he came here, boiled cabbage farts. Irish people when they got here, beer farts. And now we're so worried about these new fucking farts. I say welcome. Welcome to the new fucking farting people in this country. It's about time, you know? I mean, whatever, man. I don't know. It's just anti-immigrant, I guess. I don't know. Guys, coming to the stage. Oh, God, I hope it's cancer. Coming to the stage is somebody that I have been enjoying very much blossom in this room, and I'm looking very forward to her eventual complete disillusionment with comedy, and we can, you know, just be exactly on the same cynical fucking page. But in the meantime, she's still got a light in her eyes and a little joy in her heart. Let's give it up for Miss Hannah S.K., everybody!
Yeah, I don't have a ton of fart material. I'm not sure what I'm following right now. That was interesting. Are there any narcissists in here tonight? All right, rock and roll. Yeah, like it's a room full of comics. The question was rhetorical. I do feel like though, like ignoring the question is like, you know, the true sign of like a narcissist. I'm assuming. I didn't like do any research. I'm not qualified to diagnose mental health disorders, but like the way I see it is like, you know, like if you're like aware of something, like it can't be. Literally, I thought like I was like a narcissist, but I was like the fact that like I'm aware of this and that you know, I'm willing to acknowledge it, like immediately negates the option that like I could be a narcissist. You know, like kind of like being a hipster. Like, if someone comes up to you and says you're a hipster and you say thank you, you're not a hipster. You know, and like... I you have to like pretend like that's not a real thing. Like even though like we can still see you like through those oversized glasses. I do, this is fucking brand new. I don't like looking at my fucking phone. I don't know. Like if you're like every good hipster knows like the only response to a comment like that, and like if you're a real hipster, you know, to someone asking you or telling you you're a hipster, the only like appropriate response is I planned this out for there to be more like more obvious hipsters in the room. you guys are all posers. The only appropriate response is some version of fuck you, right? Because, like, you can't admit that you're a hipster. I do feel like that concept, like, applies to more things than, like, just, like, it applies to other mental health disorders. You know, so if you go to the doctor and, like, you know, you tell them that you're depressed or that you think you're depressed and, like, maybe antidepressants will, like, help you out. You know, and the doctor's like, well, okay, like, what kind of, like, ailments, like, do you have? And you're like, well, like, I'm kind of sad and, like lethargic. Like, I kind of want to kill myself. And it's like, well, yeah, like, those are, you know, those are some symptoms from depression that you clearly memorized off of WebMD. Get the fuck out of my office. You know, you're not getting any drugs from me, but I will prescribe you, fentanyl. Because I was paid a lot of money to push this shit. Well, I thought fentanyl was like a painkiller for late stage cancer. Yeah, no, I'm gonna prescribe this shit to you. This shit's paying for my beach house, and you're gonna fucking take this shit. I don't care what it fucking does to you. Alright. I don't know if anyone else like has ever like watched like a Netflix or HBO or whatever the fuck fucking where they have like stand-up specials where like you see like an old school comic go up and like they'll start stories off like, yeah, like I'm all for like equal human rights and stuff like that. But and then they go off and say like the worst fucking shit you've ever heard. And then they complain about like this PC culture that we live in. And I'm just like, it's not a PC culture, you just can't get on stage and say a bunch of racist, fucking prejudiced shit and call it comedy anymore. Because people will be, like, clapping and cheering for it. It's not even a comedy show anymore at that point, it's just a lukewarm hate rally. Just kind of in honor of tomorrow. I don't know if you guys are aware of the hate rally, it's kind of all I've fucking heard about for the last fucking week. So hate rallies are cool. I don't know. I'm trying to think, like, where to go from here. Like, I don't know. Like, you guys probably like abortions. You guys look like an abortion crowd. Like, I don't know. Like, there's, like, some, like, these, like, abortion, like, laws that I guess is kind of, like, old news now. But, like, I think, like, I don't know if anyone else finds it ironic that, like, a group of people that are cool with fucking their cousins are, like, now an authority on reproductive rights. Like, that would be as weird as, like, a bunch of, like, old, rich, out-of-touch dudes making laws to regulate women's bodies. Luckily, that's not fucking true, right? That's what I've been told, at least. If I've watched the fucking news, I would quote which one is the liberal and which one was the conservative one. I honestly don't fucking know. I don't watch the news. That show fucking sucks. I don't know, like, alright, so I got like a minute and 45 seconds left. Let's see. I don't know, like whenever like I make dinner for my kids, they act like they're in the second round of Fear Factor. I refuse to believe no one here is aware of Fear Factor, but in case you're not familiar, Fear Factor is basically a show where they take a group of like the most like the douchiest young Americans like of that generation and have them compete on like borderline demeaning challenges for a cash prize. And the second round is typically you know, we have to do something disgusting, like, you know, stick your head in a, like a bowl of bugs, or like eat a cadaver, or like a circus animal. Something insane, something you shouldn't be fucking eating. And Yeah, like, I don't know. Like my kids will be like, I'll bring out the food, you know, and then they start, like, sweating, like, kind of tearing up, kind of, like, weighing out their options of, like, you know, the risk-reward thing going on, and, like, eventually a kid will cave, and it's like, all right, Oliver, you've been eliminated from this round. You will not be moving on to the round of dessert, which you fucked up, because that shit's store-bought. So, I'm going to wrap it up there. All right.
Thank you, that was Hannah S.K.
Woo! Yeah.
Woo! I probably don't look like it, but I spent 6 years living in Lancaster, Pennsylvania with the Amish.
When you
might conjure some things, beards, barn raising, butter, all of them are true. However, the Amish beard, these gentlemen don't grow it until they get married. It symbolizes I'm taken to the outside world. It's like a wedding ring for your face. So imagine how awkward it was for me to move to the Pacific Northwest, where everyone is bearded. And any guy that talked to me, I'm like, oh God, I'm not a homewrecker. Because I don't want to fuck with an Amish woman. Those gals are fucking built. They raise barns. I was like, shit, if I'm going to be talking to these guys, I need to go to a gym. So I went to a gym. And they were like, what are your workout goals? And I said, I'd like to increase my vocabulary. I'd like to expand my stock portfolio. And he looked at me like, pff. And I was like, really? I just want to do enough squats so this thing looks like an outboard motor. Like, can you like coach me on how to do that? We're getting there. Our next comedian needs no help in that. She does all the squats. She makes all the jokes. Emily Duos!
It's not as bright here tonight. It's like candlelight comedy. Oh man, I haven't been here in a few weeks. Feels really good to be back. I'm glad you guys are still here and haven't gone to bed yet. Yeah, 2 weeks ago I got bit by a dog. That's not funny at all. Fucking sucked. Hindsight, I came home with two pizzas and I was like, I should give the dog a piece of pizza. It's not my dog, but I should give the dog a piece of pizza. And I ignored that little voice. And lo and behold, I got fucking bit in the thigh. And then last week, to the untrained eye, there was a large, invisible piece of glass shard sticking out of my floor, and I went to wipe up something and just shoved my finger all the way into the shard to the bone. So, gushing blood, I realized, I was like, you know, Band-Aids should really team up with maxi pads. I've come to understand that our bodies are a separate form of intelligence, and you can communicate with it. If you're really good, you can tell it what to do. I mean, aside from the obvious. I've learned that right before I started my period, I only find white candies. My body's like, hey, you know what? I should wear white today. It's gonna look really good. And the rest of the month, they creep back into the shadows of my apartment. I'm more likely to get kicked in the shadows. All right, let's see. Anyone ever sit on a toilet so low? You feel like you're laying down? I had to stay in a room that had a handicap bathroom, and I was literally like squatting down with my head between my knees, shitting, which I think is how you're supposed to do it. But I was like, fuck, this is actually kind of comfortable. I bet if I shaved my pussy in this position, I'd probably get hurt a lot less in the shower. So I started a game with myself called Me / Real Me. Usually when I'm hungover in the mornings, hanging out, trying to fall back asleep. Sitting at my kitchen table, I was like, man, my citronella plant like really smells like B.O. sometimes. Real Me, it's not the plant. It's you.
But...
Oh man, let's see. Where's the time? All right, I can tell a story. So last night, I only gave a dance to one person, but I gave my phone number to two people. The person I gave the dance to wasn't the person I really wanted to give a dance to. I mean, I wanted to make the money and give the dance, but the other person that I gave my phone number to was one I was really eyeing. Sometimes you win. I have really bad PTSD right now because this is like the anniversary of that situation, and so I just randomly black out, sober or drunk. And this morning I get a text, and it was like, you mean, or first, yeah, first one was like, plays into Me, Real Me, at 2:20 a.m. Hey, remember me? I was like, yes, I do. I was just like, literally just like, who did I just give my phone number to? later on, I get a text, so this morning, he says, oh, hey, hope you made it home safely. I was like, yeah, thanks, I did. I was like, I hope you had a nice night in your nutshell. And he was like, I was like, hey, Bart, you know, like, so stoked. I was like, fuck yeah. The really hot guy texted me. I was like, Bart? Who's Bart? I was like, fuck. I never use names on, like, the next day text ever. The one time I do, I'm so sure of myself. Lucky for me, apparently in the Urban Dictionary, Bart is like a loving, caring, sporty guy. So, like, he sent the Urban Dictionary, like, photo. I was like, that could have gone really bad, because we all know the Urban Dictionary. And he's like, yeah, and actually, my night went really well, thanks to our, my nutshell is fine, thanks. Because my night went really well, thanks to the dance. And I was like, oh, right. I don't even remember the fucking punchline now. Oh man. Maybe that was the punchline. Alright, I think I'm gonna cap it off there because I'm just apparently blanking out. But thanks, you guys.
Amelia Duos, everybody! Oh man. You know, Amelia is a fucking awesome comedian, and I really hate to go in the direction I'm gonna go, but I gotta go with the material I wrote. So I've recently gotten into butt play, and I kind of arrived at it. Here's the thing. There's no sex shame, right? We're not slut shaming me for, you know, enjoying my orifices. They're mine, right? I can do. But I think I should. Here's the thing. I was just enjoying a little masturbation on the recliner, like normal. And it's summertime, and I do a lot of outdoor work, and so I'm just itchy butthole is what led me to fucking. But I say whatever gets you there. I say whatever gets you to, but the other thing I discovered is that I haven't discovered that I haven't been with anybody in a long time, but I did discover during the same itchy butthole situation that if you don't wash your ass and you do a lot of yard work for like 3 days, your butt crack does smell like high school pussy. It absolutely does smell like yeasty, fucking, because let me tell you something, sugar and spice my ass. Nobody in high school washes their ass, all right? It's everybody's dirty. That's where we all come together. You guys, come to the stage with somebody. We were playing the fucking tag game for a little while. I'm glad to see him in here this evening. Let's give it up for our headline comedian this evening, Mr. Talon Stanley, everybody. There you go, buddy.
I am about to lower the shit out of your expectations.
Yes!
Headline comedian is a heavy, heavy phrase. Believe it or not, I am into fitness. I know it's very difficult to believe. But I actually ran here today. There goes my fucking camera. I ran here today Which, side note, did you know that moms get really mad when you punch their baby in the mouth? That's how you learn and that's how you get fit. A couple weeks ago, my grandmother came to town, and she said out of nowhere, Talon, do you smoke weed? I said, yeah, Grammy, I do. She said, what the fuck? I would have brought you some. I actually knew that. She's quite the stoner. She grows all kinds of plants and stuff. She's been part of the whole movement since, like, the 50s. But she said, now she sends me all kinds of pictures and stuff after I told her that. She's real proud of them, and it's the cutest fucking thing ever. My sister had a baby 2 weeks ago. Beautiful little baby boy. Fuck that baby. This is cuter. This is way better than that brand new fucking perfect baby. I've learned that some people, has a story. Not everybody has a story that you want to hear. There are stories about Miralax coffee and a banana. And not everybody wants to hear it. I do have regrets. Oh, also, I am part of the generation people call trophy babies, so fuck you guys for not laughing. I deserve that. I'm getting married soon. It's going to be about 3 weeks, which... 3 weeks. Fuck! Mm-hmm. 3 fucking weeks. That's... Yeah, I'm going to have a heart attack right here. He's going to have to save me. But also, fuck you to all the women who rejected me before. There are so many of them. My fiance, she's a wonderful woman. She decided not to come tonight, which, I mean, I understand. I feel bad for the 5 of you that have to deal with my 7 minutes of bullshit. And I also learned through wedding planning that jewelry stores don't have the best return policy. I tried, and now I'm 3 weeks away from a wedding. I want to get a tattoo of a boob, like a literal tit, right here, because then I can say I have a titty tat. Tell someone I have a titty tat. Oh, you have a cat? No. Titty tat. You guys ever notice the abundance of stepmother, stepbrother porn? I think that tells us what's wrong with America. So many people get turned on by the idea of almost fucking your almost mother or almost sister. That is dangerously close to incest. We need to address this. Another thing that we need to address. There's always that porn star, the teen porn star, that's getting a little bit older. You still see they're young, but they're getting a little bit older. And you gotta think, you have grandkids now? You should probably step up an age bracket because the whole teen thing isn't working for your geriatric ass.
Huh.
I gotta hope that I never get famous, which at this rate, I won't. But I hope I never do, because I'm gonna go straight fucking Charlie Sheen and Joey Diaz fucking coke every day. Not on purpose, but I know that's how I'll be, because it's fucking fun. So this is kind of a story that I gotta tell. It's not even a joke, it's just a story that people need to hear. The other day I was going down I-205 and I saw the damnedest thing in a shit brown purplish, most disgusting car I've ever seen, PT Cruiser. But there was something sticking out of the driver's seat window that I swear was a dog. I got closer, it was a fucking goat. Who sees a goat in a driver's seat? But I don't know, but it was wonderful, and I'm so glad you guys got to hear that. Made my whole night. When I was a kid, well, not even when I was a kid, until about 3 years ago, I never thought I would get laid. Obviously, I'm getting married, so it has not happened yet, because I'm a child of Jesus. I was prepared to have to pay for a hooker, because nothing was happening. I'm like, well, I guess I better start saving now. Mow all the lawns that I need to. Do you guys remember the DARE program? Or as I like to call it, what do you ask your dealer? He teach you everything you need to know. I was in fifth grade. I learned what a joint was, what a blunt was, what a bong was. I even found out the word for crack. I was having so much fun as an 11-year-old. You guys remember LimeWire? Years ago, I'd be able to download free music. It was great because you start thinking about it. It's a lot like having sex with Portland women because it's great. You have these expectations. You're going to have good music, good sounds. You get those good music and getting good sounds, but then you go back and check the hardware the next day and something has gone terribly wrong. You guys have a good night.
Tom Stanley, everybody, bring in that young man. Tom, I got a question for you. I think I know the answer. How old are you? You should just stand up here and say, I'm 20 years old and I'm getting married. I think that'll just get all the fucking laughs. I'm 20 years old, I'm getting married. God damn it, everybody would just laugh their asses off. That is as shocking and as upsetting as that is. I'm going to close you off with something that I just discovered that's, I think, so much more upsetting, is that there's the smell of maple syrup emanating from the kitchen of a Chinese food restaurant, and I don't know what fucking nightmare that's attached to. Are there some Canadian Chinese people back there? I don't know. I don't want to fucking know. But if I might ask for a sample, and if I'm here in the future, then I survive. You guys, thank you so much for coming out to HotBox. Thank you for Amy Phillips for coming in and being my co-host this weekend. Thank you, Ben. Thank you guys for coming in and watching. This is what an open mic really is, right? It's not a show. It's not an open mic. You basically were watching people at the gym, which, honestly, that's kind of weird on your part. If I'm being fully honest, but, you know, that's why they put the fucking burlap sacks in front of curves. We're kind of like curves. Which, by the way, is there a worse fucking window dressing you could put in front of fucking curves than a bunch of fucking potato fucking sacks? That just seems kind of mean. I don't know. Really piling on those people. You guys, thank you once again so much for coming out. Look for us online. Subscribe to the HotBox YouTube channel, which is not currently called the HotBox YouTube channel, but if I get like 60 more of you fuckers to subscribe, I might be able to change the name. Thank you once again. Good night, everybody.
Let's do this shit for real. Come on now.